center with Terry Fair, and I believe they'll do it again. Well, you can look at the starting lineups here. You can see the height difference we've been talking about. Look at that front line of Carolina's particularly. But don't underestimate Georgia because they can leap.
And the Bulldogs throw it away. Not a good way to start a basketball game to throw the first one away, particularly after you got the tip.
Well, if you like experience, obviously you got to go with Carolina. You like enthusiasm and talent, you got to give Georgia a chance.
Well, the thing about it, Frank, is that Georgia really has more older players. They've got a couple of juniors and seniors, and North Carolina really has the youngest team.
5 seconds. Little pressure by Georgia paying off.
We talked about the quickness, and Georgia has a lot of it.
Lamar Hurd, who was a sixth man last year, down to Vern Fleming. Fleming got into foul trouble the other night, scored only 10 points before fouling out. They immediately go inside, and Terry Fair going up for the shot is fouled. Big Brett Doherty, the 6'11 freshman, picks up the first foul.
A little bit of surprise here. Terry Fair going in against the big guys inside, but he's big enough to get in there himself. He's only 6'7", but he really powers to the basket.
Fair had his career game Friday night against St. John's at 27 points. In that contest and 9 rebounds. He's normally known as a defensive player. Georgia is on the scoreboard first. Terry, a 6'7 senior from Macon, Georgia.
One of the things you can expect to see from Georgia is right after this main free throw, but they didn't make it, but they'll pick up in a press full court.
Doherty with the rebound to Braddock. Braddock was the three-point specialist during the ACC season, but of course no three-point shot in the NCAA tournament. Carolina throws it away. That's 2 turnovers here in the first 30 seconds of the game for Carolina.
And again, they're showing a little bit of us tonight what they did against St. John's. The good quickness in the second half was what won the game for them Friday night.
First time ever for Georgia in an NCAA playoff, and they're one game away from the Final Four. Gerald Crosby looking for help underneath. Picked off by Braddock. Tim Braddock goes to Jordan. Jordan had an off night, hitting only 5 out of 15. The other night, one of his poor shooting games of the year. Doherty kind of forcing that shot and is fouled by number 25, James Banks.
Another bad play by Matt Doherty. He knew he was going to draw the foul that time and went ahead and decided to put it up. It's like a pro basketball play. You'll see it again right here. Banks right there tried to lean back away from him, but he got Doherty on the way up.
Matt, one of 3 starters from the defending championship team. 77% free throw shooter. Dean Smith leaning back early, and Hugh Durham, he does not sit down very much during a ball game.
He roams the sidelines up and down in front of his bench.
He and Lou Carnesecca really put on a show on the sidelines here tonight. 2-1, Carolina with the lead. The game is just 1 minute old here at the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York.
North Carolina's playing straight up man-to-man right now.
Gerald Crosby.
Good trap right there, and Georgia beat it.
Banks outside to Vern Fleming. Fleming is from New York City. Played against one of his old friends, Mr. Mullen from St. John's the other night, and acquitted himself right well. Crosby from 22. Jordan grabs the rebound for the Tar Heels. Braddock, open shot from 20. And neither team hitting in the early going.
Frank, the pace has really been very quick for both clubs, but neither one of them have been able to hit any shots.
Almost 2 minutes deep in the game, and we're still looking for our first basket. Carolina leading 2-1. Crosby outside to Fleming. Turn around from 14. Fleming hustling after his own rebound. Good block by Perkins. Jordan comes down with it. Here come the Tar Heels. Braddock, who took a lot of flack at the beginning of the season after he succeeded Jimmy Black as the point guard, but he's come on strong in the second half of the year. He runs the show. His job, get the ball to the big guys. Perkins is fouled underneath by Hurd.
We talked about the size of North Carolina. You see Fleming right there with a shot. He missed it. They banged around inside, and Fleming came back with it. Watch Perkins come in and block the ball right there, and that's what Georgia cannot do. They cannot take it inside against a much taller Tar Heel team.
They rule it a non-shooting violation, so Carolina will take it out underneath their offensive hoop. Brad Doherty, the big freshman in the middle who's come through for Dean Smith this year, slapped away by Georgia. Hurd down to Crosby. Gerald Crosby, pull-up jumper. Nope.
Still looking for our first basket. Perkins with the rebound. Gets it down to Braddock quickly. Cross-court pass. Michael Jordan takes things into his own hands, and he can't hit it.
Well, need a club can buy a basket.
Jerry Fair down to Fleming. On the drive, yes.
Good move, and he did it around Perkins, who's probably their best defensive player inside.
Fleming gets the first basket of the game, which comes 2 minutes and 45 seconds deep into the contest. It's 3-2, Georgia.
You see Georgia matched up. They're playing a straight man-to-man, but when the ball comes in, they really give a lot of help away from the ball.
North Carolina with two great All-Americans and Michael Jordan and Sam Perkins, who has the basketball here. Back to Braddock. He hit 46% of his three-point attempts during the regular season, and Braddock gets the first basket of the game for the Tar Heels. Crosby open from the corner. Short from 15, Perkins with the rebound. Sam Perkins, who played his high school basketball right in this area at Latham, New York. Wound up his junior and senior year, was heavily recruited by Syracuse. Got it down to Carolina and Syracuse, and finally decided to go south. Here's Jordan on the drive. Gets his own rebound. Still can't get it to go down. Fleming. To Crosby. Crosby walks.
Good fast break opportunity by Georgia that time was lost simply by Crosby. Couldn't handle the basketball. Watch Jordan here at the end of the play right here. It was Fair who intimidated him. He got the ball back, but he couldn't come up with the rebound basket right there. Fleming got it going the other way. At the end of that play is what happened with the Crosby travel with the basketball. Fleming, a lot of intimidation. He and Fair are very strong on the offensive board.
Georgia has hit 1 out of 6 so far. Carolina, 1 out of 5. Braddock inside to Doherty. Matt Doherty with that miss. Rebound to Hurd. Down it comes quickly. Fleming misses from 15 feet. And we get a foul.
Looks like it's Curtis Hunter, Frank. He was inside there, and Jim Howe, the official, caught him pushing someone.
Hunter, the 6'4 freshman from Durham, North Carolina. That's his first foul, the team's second foul.
Well, both clubs are really cold in the early going.
Are they ever?
Now North Carolina's in a zone. Looks like a 2-3, maybe a little bit more of a matchup.
25 for Georgia is James Banks, who won the Virginia Commonwealth shot with that basket in the last few seconds. Gerald Crosby.
Pretty good patience being shown by Georgia right now. You see North Carolina pack that zone back inside. Fair got it.
Terry Fair with the slam. Georgia leads it 5-4 with 15:25 left to play in the first half.
You really wouldn't have anticipated a pass inside the way North Carolina had that zone defense so packed inside. But they did get it to Fair, and he did a couple of those Friday night, too.
Durham doing his facing act. Hugh, a lot of years at Florida State before coming to Georgia. This is his fifth year. Third tournament he's got him in. Two in the NIT, but the first time ever in the NCAA. Braddock on top to Doherty. Matt Doherty on the drive.
Good help that time by Crosby to cut off Doherty's drive.
That's Perkins' first shot of the game. Sam Perkins, 6'9 junior All-American. And a mighty force last year at Carolina's drive for the national championship. 6'5, Carolina leads it.
North Carolina's come back into their man-to-man defense now. Dean Smith will give you so many different kinds of looks. A lot of defensive pressure.
Crosby, number 4 here, can't get hot and has done so. That one rejected. Terry Fair going up with a shot. And Sam Perkins. I think Terry's going to wind up with Spalding printed all over his forehead if he keeps that move.
Watch the play right here. You'll see the ball come in on a good pass from Vern Fleming. He threaded it through that North Carolina zone. That's Terry Fair. That's one. Watch this one. An ISO on Fair. He's in front of Doherty. Good position. Offensive position to receive the pass. Took it up and jammed it.
Time out. With
just carrying over to this afternoon's game.
You know, you wonder, losing Dominique Wilkins, you figure this wouldn't be a better team, but it is. One reason is they play great defense. Doherty with the miss. Crosby kicks it down court quickly to Banks. They do move it around, too. Vern Fleming with the miss and then the follow for the two-pointer.
Good ball movement by the Bulldogs that time. Hurd got it inside to Fleming, and Fleming is devastating inside when he gets the ball there. 6'5 guard.
Georgia not intimidated, at least to this point, by Carolina. 11-9. Bulldogs lead it.
Now Georgia's changed defenses. They've gone to a 1-3-1. You see Fleming on the point there. Fair kind of roams the middle, and they put their quick guys, Hurd and Crosby, inside.
Sam Perkins to Michael Jordan, who's been quiet so far, and Jordan gets his first basket of the game. Georgia gets...
Look at that move by Fleming.
Fleming with a great move, but he couldn't capitalize and pick up the two-pointer. Doherty weaving back and forth. Score tied at 11. Short, two quick baskets for the Tar Heels, and Carolina has the lead at 13-11.
Pace picking up a little bit now. Both clubs beginning to play a little bit better brand of basketball.
Hasn't been a bad weekend for competitive games on CBS.
Two and great ones yesterday.
Yes, so this shapes up to be another one. Fleming with the pass. Tries to go inside. Matt Doherty with the save. And right back outside it goes to Lamar Hurd. Good role player for the Georgia Bulldogs. Hurd settles it down, gets it back to Crosby. Gerald Crosby from Birmingham, Alabama, controlling. He's a 6'1 sophomore.
Banks got it. Boy, that was a good shot, too, because Matt Doherty was coming over to double team, and Grant Doherty right in front of him with both hands raised. Good shot by Banks.
Hadn't been a bad weekend for Georgia basketball. Their women's team is in the quarterfinals of the NCAA tournament. We'll have that final game for you next Sunday here on CBS. So quite a year for the Bulldogs basketball fortunes.
North Carolina appears to try to push the ball inside.
Michael Jordan at the one-handed alley-oop. Spectacular.
What a great play, and they timed it perfectly.
15-13.
That brought the Tar Heel fans to their feet.
I'll tell you, the band loved it. Banks coming right back. James Banks pops for two from 15 feet away. And we're tied at 15.
Frank, that's an interesting point right there. James Banks came back right after that Jordan slam. It shows you a little bit of the maturity the Bulldogs have got. They've got a very experienced basketball team.
Fourth time we've been tied. Here's Brad Doherty trying to get inside. Turn around, jumper goes. Big Brad Doherty, the 6'11 freshman, gets his second basket. And puts Georgia within 2 points here, 17-15.
Both clubs now beginning to play very well. Their shooting has improved.
Double team. On fair, he got it away to Crosby, and Crosby hits.
Well, they're lighting the place up now, both teams.
Carolina has hit its last four shots from the field. So after a slow start by both sides, they are really going to town. Perkins to Braddock. Matt Doherty gets it to Jordan. Jordan trying to drive on Fleming. Turns around. Oh! Doherty with the rebound. Matt Doherty on the follow shot for Carolina. Doherty. 19-17. Carolina's getting ready to send in three players. They use just about everybody on the bench. They had 10 players in the ballgame Friday night against Ohio State before the first half was over. Banks gets another one.
Three in a row for James Banks.
6'6 junior from Atlanta, Georgia hits, and we're knotted at 19.
Interesting the way this game started, Frank. It really started very slow. Neither club could shoot. Then the last 3 to 5 minutes, they really have been shooting the ball extremely well because they've both gotten good shots.
Brad Doherty to Perkins. Field goal percentage has really picked up, as you can see. Matt Doherty on the outside. You forget that Matt Doherty is 6'8". He handles the ball so well for a big man. Jordan. Missing from 22 feet. We've got a foul called underneath.
Looks like Doherty inside. Brad Doherty pushed off for North Carolina. It'll go to Georgia.
Second foul on Brad Doherty, and on Carolina, their third team foul. Take a look at that jam a few moments ago by Michael Jordan, number 23.
Watch the pass by Matt Doherty. That's the key to it right there, and that guy can really get up.
He was named this week as the Sporting News College Basketball Player of the Year.
Frank, look at the way he plays. He plays with his mouth open constantly. That time he was up there so high, he could have lost it with oxygen.
Bill Walton in the championship game that year.
Of course, that was when he was at Florida State, Frank, and he was a great basketball coach down there for 12 years.
12 years at Florida State, 5 years now at Georgia. And what is impressive about this Bulldog team, among other things, the way they play defense. They forced turnovers. They forced St. John's into 18 turnovers the other night, and they have averaged forcing their opponents into an average of 18 a game. That's a lot of turnovers.
Well, it really is, and it points out how good they are defensively. You see right there a foul committed. Crosby trying to drive the baseline. Durham going back to his bench right now. They're tied at 19 right now simply because their defense has forced North Carolina out away from the inside of the basket.
Crosby has been hot. Short this time from 22 feet. What a collision between Hale at the free throw line, who came in during the timeout, and Terry Fair. Steve Hale, 6'3 freshman from Jenks, Oklahoma, picks up the foul.
We talked about the offensive ability of Terry Fair. You see some of the offensive rebounding ability of him there. He's a good 15 feet from the basket, got away from the inside of it to go draw that foul from Steve Hale.
They've put in, Carolina has Warren Martin in the middle. He had an excellent game the other night against Ohio State. Jordan got a quick breather, but he's back in the contest. So Carolina's got Matt Doherty in there. They've got Jordan in. They've got Hale, Perkins, and Martin.
That was a good blow for Michael Jordan. A good thing to take out, as Dean Smith does often, some of his players, his starters, and give them a little bit of a blow.
Donald Hartree, number 30 for Georgia. Good freshman point guard has come into the game. Lamar Hurd with his first shot of the game, and he pockets it for 2 points.
I'll tell you what, that was a rainbow, too, because Warren Martin at 7 feet was fully extended, and he shot it completely over his body and outstretched hand.
21-19, Bulldogs hanging in there. 7:40 left to play first half. Warren Martin outside to Jordan. Hale's dad used to be the basketball coach at Oral Roberts University. Great young player from Oklahoma who has cast his fate with the Tar Heels. Knocked out of bounds, Georgia's ball. One thing that's impressed me about the Bulldogs is they refuse to be intimidated by the North Carolina reputation, the mystique, whatever it is. They played them last year in regular season, not this past season, but a year ago at Greensboro, and lost by 9, 66-57.
And Frank, that was after playing at LSU on a Saturday, in which they won, and then they turned around and flew all the way to Greensboro to play the next day.
And that was with Dominique Wilkins, of course. Hartree takes aim, doesn't shoot it. Inside to Fair, Lamar Hurd deep in the corner. Got it! Oh, yeah!
Georgia playing well right now, and they're up by four. They're doing it with defense, they're doing it with good shot selection.
23-19. This will be Georgia's biggest lead of the ball game. Just under 7 minutes left to play in the first half, and we get a whistle and a foul called away from the ball.
That's a mismatch right there. You see Crosby against Jordan, and Crosby committed the foul against Jordan. Jordan posted him up inside, which is a good idea. Michael Jordan at 6'5", Crosby at 6'1". North Carolina tried to push the ball inside, but Crosby pushed Jordan before they can get the ball there.
And you saw Bert Fleming come back into the ball game for Georgia. He's been the guy who has carried them down the stretch. They were absolutely brilliant in the Southeast Conference tournament. They blew everybody away, winning by 14, 19, and 15 points in their three games.
They were not even tested in the Southeastern Conference tournament. They had an average margin of 16 points in their win.
Jordan bangs it home. Michael Jordan with his fourth basket. 23-21, Georgia. Braddock is getting ready to come back into the game. Pull up, jumper goes. Everybody hits. This one by James Banks. He gets his fourth hoop. Every time Carolina scores, it seems Georgia comes back.
Georgia shooting very well right now, Frank. They've really picked up their shooting proficiency. If they keep going like that and play the type of defense they're playing, they could really come out of this first half in great shape.
Inside to Perkins. The 10-footer doesn't go, and a lot of shoveling between Terry Fair and Martin going on underneath, and this time I believe they got Fair. Brad Doherty comes back into the game for Carolina. Hale comes out. Perkins comes out. Hunter comes back in. You need a traffic cop.
It was a pretty good shoving match inside that time by Terry Fair and Warren Martin. They're two big players. Fair weighs about 225, Martin up around 245, and it was a standoff at the OK Corral. Neither one of them could move.
Five team fouls apiece here in the first half, which is 5:55 left. Pass inside to Braddock. He didn't pick it up, but Hunter did. And Hunter puts it back in the hole. Curtis Hunter, 6'4 freshman from Durham, gets his first basket of the game.
I think North Carolina does extremely well. They pick up a lot of loose balls.
Georgia obviously doesn't care for the shot clock. They've done very well without it.
Got a foul on Curtis Hunter right there. He reached in and grabbed him on the backside. It'll be Georgia's foul for Georgia's ball, but that was the sixth foul on North Carolina, so Georgia will go to the line from now on and shoot the one and one.
Bulldogs playing Carolina tough. No one quite knew what to expect of this team. After all, they only finished 9-9 in their own conference. All nine of their losses this year were in the conference. Fleming!
Well, they are burning the court on the inside right now. I don't think they've missed a shot the last seven trips down the floor.
27-23. Georgia leading. Braddock on the outside.
Now they go to a 2-3 zone. They're getting away from that man-to-man and try to pack it inside and keep the ball from coming inside to Martin and Doherty.
Braddock, just like it was a three-pointer.
And that's how you beat zones. You find a guy like Jimmy Braddock who can shoot it from 22 feet, just like he did.
Braddock is another one of those Dean Smith guys who would run through a wall for his coach. Finds a lot of those backcourt players for some reason. Georgia has hit its last four shots. They are smoking and leading 27-25. Fleming cross-court pass to Hartree. Lamar Hurd with the fadeaway from 15. And Martin grabs the rebound.
But again, Frank, they had a good shot. Nobody came after Hurd. He was standing wide open on the baseline.
A lot of height in there right now for Carolina. They've got two 6'11 players. Got Doherty, who's 6'8. There's Grant Doherty in the middle. We're talking about all the height, and probably their two best players are not in the game right now. And Jordan and Perkins, who are about to come back into the contest. Both named to numerous All-American teams this year. Tied at 27. 4 minutes left to play in the first half. The winner gets North Carolina State next Saturday in Albuquerque.
What's Georgia's patience on offense right here? They're going to take the basketball, try to move it around this perimeter of North Carolina's zone defense. Now North Carolina comes out of that zone, and they go man-to-man.
After a very slow start, Georgia's hit 13 out of 27.
Great pass.
DeFair inside. He couldn't get the basket, but he got the goaltending.
Frank, you got to give Georgia a lot of credit for recognizing the switch in the defenses by North Carolina. They immediately went to Ferris. As soon as North Carolina went away from that zone to that man-to-man, they hit him inside, and he blew right by Martin.
Carolina, of course, will do that to you. They'll switch defenses sometimes. Every time
on CBS. A bit later on to Kansas City for Villanova and some more high flyers, the Houston Cougars.
Winner of that game will play Louisville next Saturday on CBS. The Final Four at Albuquerque. And North Carolina State and Jim Valvano's Cinderella team waiting in the wings for this one. That's the way the rebound story has gone so far. Perkins. Foul by Lamar Hurd. Perkins has not been that much of a factor, but he's the type of guy that all of a sudden, wham, he can take off on you.
Well, he'll go to sleep on you for about 6 or 8 minutes, and all of a sudden, he'll get electrified and come out of there and hit 5 or 6 baskets on you, make a couple of steals, a couple of jams. So don't expect him to stay subdued all day long. He's a good basketball player.
16 fouls on Georgia, so both sides will be in the bonus the rest of the way for the first half. There's an alley. Jordan with his second alley-oop. And again, the North Carolina band. On a scale of 1 to 10, I think they love it. They think he's in a high-diving meet.
Somebody put a 9 up there. I don't believe that.
No, that's a 10. That other one was a 10, too, I think. Carolina band does that for the whole ball game. They will grade the slam dunks. Fleming with the miss. Rebound. Lamar Hurd. That's where they did it against St. John's in the second half on the offensive boards. They just stay after it. The tenacious Bulldog, Hunter, missing from 15 feet. Carrying the power down to Fleming. Banks on the drive. Foul by Jordan.
Frank, I'll tell you one thing about Georgia. They're not the least intimidated by this North Carolina club right now. Here's Michael Jordan with his stuff. Watch it. Is it a 10? I think so.
That's at least 3 tens that he's received from the band in this tournament. Two this afternoon. James Banks, as we said, heavily recruited by Dean Smith, who wanted him very badly to go to North Carolina. But he decided to cast his lot instead with the building program at Georgia. Banks played his high school ball in Atlanta on a team that won the mythical high school championship.
Frank, I think an interesting thing about James Banks is he started every game since he's come to Georgia, and he's played more minutes than anybody on this club this year.
Bulldogs by 3. And now by 4. Substitute coming into the game for the Georgia Bulldogs, Derek Floyd. Derek's had some knee injury problems in the past that he's been fighting the last couple of years.
A
Well, there's the front line scoring right there. Georgia really taking it to them. 23-13 differential.
Now let's see. Braddock brings it out near center court. Going to start it all over again. Again, the try on the alley-oop.
Jordan got it anyway.
Got it on the rebound this time and put it up with the left hand.
He was screened away that time and couldn't get to the basketball on the lob, and it came off the board, and he was standing there waiting for it.
Bulldogs by two, 33-31. North Carolina with a record of 28-7 coming in. Georgia with a mark of 23-9. 20-win season is a rarity in Athens.
Hartree, the freshman. Donald Hartree from Milledgeville, Georgia. Getting his first basket. North Carolina needs to get a little bit more aggressive on defense. Georgia's really lighting them up from the outside. They're hitting good baseline jumpers, and they're getting into the seams of that North Carolina 1-3-1 and shooting very well.
These teams have played 12 times down through the years, and Carolina has won 8 of those matchups, the last being 1 year ago, as we talked about earlier. Matt Doherty outside with Braddock, down to a minute and 30-second mark. Hey, Carolina did a classic job, put on a clinic against Ohio State the other night with the four corners. With 7 minutes to go in that game, they were up 4, and they wound up winning it by 13. Jordan,
I think he can feel it. He's starting to get on a roll now. He scored very well there in the first half. Played much better than he did Friday night here in the Carrier Dome.
Michael Jordan with 12. We've got a minute 5 left to play in the first half. Georgia by 2, 35-33. Michael Jordan has hit 7 out of 13 from the field after a slow start.
Georgia,
they double-teamed the freshman, Hartree.
I was going to say, Georgia may want to consider holding this ball, but no, Ferris going to shoot it. Got it.
Off the glass for 2. Carey Fair. He has 9 points, senior from Macon. And again, the Bulldogs have a 4-point advantage. 40 seconds left to play in the half.
Unless something goes awry, Georgia could go out of here and end the lead in the first half, which is going to be a surprise to a lot of people. But their quickness has really been displayed here in the first half. Defensively, they've done a good job against North Carolina, and they've taken good high percentage shots.
Matt Doherty, as we hit the 20-second mark, to Braddock. Georgia doing a good job jamming up the middle, preventing Carolina from getting that ball inside to Brad Doherty. Braddock to Jordan. Jordan, 2. Michael Jordan carrying North Carolina down the stretch here in the first half. Hartree off the glass and almost banged it home from 30 feet away. Great first half here in Syracuse, and the fans on their feet applauding.
For that.
44 years old, he was considered for the head coaching job with the Boston Celtics prior to Bill Fitch getting that job after the great work he did at Florida State, where one of his players was Dave Cowens. Carolina to inbound. They are down by 2. And they will dance with who brung them. Same starting 5 in there for Carolina. Brad Doherty, the 6'11 center. Georgia with a big edge in the front line scoring so far. Jordan.
North Carolina went to their money man to start the second half. He had 16 in the first half, but he didn't get it that time. Georgia with a chance to push it to 4.
Well, they got to get more out of Perkins, don't they?
He really went to sleep the first half. I don't know what happened to him, but Jordan really had to pick up his load, too. Look for Sam Perkins to become a little bit more active here in the second half.
Vern Fleming on the outside. Open shot. Gerald Crosby.
Oh, there's Bill.
Crosby with his 3rd long-range basket. And Georgia has a 4-point lead. That matches their biggest lead of the afternoon so far.
And Georgia's in a man-to-man defense right now.
To the winner, the right to play North Carolina State in Albuquerque in the Final Four next Saturday. Matt Doherty to Braddock. This is a veteran tournament team. They're used to a pressure situation. And they've got a battle on their hands. Doherty, no foul. Saved by Brad Doherty. Inside it goes to Michael Jordan.
Oh, what a play by Jordan on the pass out.
Brad Doherty is fouled. That shows you the great athletic ability of Michael Jordan. In that split second in the air, he decides whether to pass or to shoot.
And he was coming down, Frank, and he decided, I cannot get this shot off. And he turned around and found Matt Doherty on the side over there. Watch this play again. You'll see Michael Jordan with the basketball. He starts up, has no chance for a shot, then turns around and flips it to Matt Doherty, who gets it inside to Brad Doherty, who goes up and draws the foul. Doherty goes to the line for 2 shots.
17-year-old freshman, 65% free throw shooter on the year. He's 2 out of 2 from the line so far this afternoon, has a total of 8 points. 22,984 on hand. The configuration here, seats 33,000. And of course, had Syracuse been here this week, chances are they would have filled it. Inside, it's Terry Fairs. Fairs sneaks one in by Sam Perkins.
I just can't get over it. I'm surprised how Georgia has taken it inside against North Carolina. They're taking it to Daugherty and Perkins, and Fair got another basket here in the second half, and they did the same thing in the first half.
41-37. Brad Daugherty on top to Braddock. They're looking for Jordan on the alley-oop, but he wasn't open that time.
Pretty good matchup inside with Fleming and Jordan.
Kick by Georgia. It'll be Carolina's ball. Jordan kind of floats around in that offense, doesn't he? Almost freelancing at times.
Well, Frank, he almost floats on offense and defense. I think Dean Smith gives him enough latitude to go ahead and play anywhere he wants to go. You see Fleming on Michael Jordan right there. That's a change defensively.
Basket will count. And he was fouled.
It's very difficult to stay up with Michael Jordan one-on-one. Here's Fleming. We talked about the defensive change. You see Fleming just trying to belly up to Jordan right there, and he went right by him and laid it in and drew it. Going to get a three-point opportunity.
First foul of the game on Fleming, who fouled out the other night. And they want it despite him. Jordan is the main man for Carolina. 19 points of his team's total of 40. And he has brought Carolina within one, 41-40. Lamar Hurd to Fleming, jump shooting. Over Daugherty, rebound, Jordan, he's everywhere. Braddock, down it comes to Matt Daugherty.
Oh, man!
Perkins was shoved from behind by Terry Fair. Second foul on Fair. That is the third team foul on Georgia early in the second half, and that could be a factor free throw shooting wise later on.
Well, that could be a big factor. Terry Fair was a little upset right there. You see the frown on his face, but watch this North Carolina bring. Friday got it, Daugherty. Daugherty looked up, laid it off the glass. You see the move right there, and there's Fair pushing Perkins. It's a good call. He was on his back.
Here's Braddock. Trying to get it inside to Perkins, and they get Perkins for shoving off.
A little bit of reversal of roles right there. Perkins trying to establish good post position inside. He had it. He had a wide base, but the official felt like he pushed off to establish that position.
Perkins has been troubled some by a sore toe in the last week or so. He had a fair game the other night by his standards, but not a great game. And, of course, he's having his problems so far. Richard Corrin into the game for the very first time for the Georgia Bulldogs. Corrin is a 6'6 sophomore from Albany, Georgia. Bulldogs leading 41-40. Taking everything that Carolina has to offer and throwing it right back at them.
North Carolina in the zone defense now, 1-3-1.
Crosby, got it.
Well, Georgia keeps lighting up the North Carolina zone defense. They have not been very successful in stopping the Bulldogs from shooting from that range.
Crosby has four baskets, and all have been from 18 feet or beyond. 43-40, Perkins. Braddock had the open shot, but he saw Jordan closer and got it inside. And Jordan is fouled.
Here's Neil scouting instructions right there to his club. Frank, it's very difficult to try to stop Michael Jordan inside like that one-on-one.
Dean Smith, of course, has the coach's hat trick, I guess you'd call it. He's won an NCAA championship, an NIT championship, and an Olympic championship. Jordan with five rebounds. Terry Fair has got some foul problems now on the bench. So Jordan continues to keep Carolina close. 21 points for Jordan. Exactly half his team's total.
Frank, I was going to say, at some point in time, Carolina's going to have to start getting somebody else involved in the offense. And here's a turnover. It could be going North Carolina's way. You start to feel a little momentum starting to shift in the Tar Heels' direction.
Bulldogs turn it over. Pressure applied by Georgia in the backcourt. Now they drop off as Braddock brings it down.
Losing Fair is going to be very crucial to Georgia right now because they need his offensive and defensive rebounding inside. They're going to have to change their defenses and go away from their man-to-man. They've gone to a zone, just what we expected them to do.
Sam Perkins from 20. Sam can't get it to go down today. Rebound, Lamar Hurd. Brings it down quickly. Hurd, 6'5", senior from Cartersville, Georgia. The James Banks. Georgia Banks, one of the most underrated players probably in the Southeast Conference this year.
Georgia may go to a little bit different look on offense now, with a little bit more patience and a little bit less fast breaking, because they've got their big stick out of the lineup right now, and that's Terry Fair.
Hurd playing in a high post, almost throws it away. Got by Fleming, but Crosby was there to pick it off. Georgia trying to be patient on offense. Corin going over Perkins. Sam Perkins intimidated. Lamar Hurd was there for the follow. Once again, one of those second chance baskets for Georgia. Matt Doherty.
Good shot by Doherty. Here comes Georgia back.
Fleming. I can't keep up with it.
They do that so well. When that basketball falls through that net, Georgia will grab it and run out, and that's the first chance they've had to run against North Carolina. The Tar Heels that time not back on defense.
47-44, Bulldogs with the lead. 15:40 left to play. Braddock inside, knocked away by the quick Bulldogs. Corin with the steal, down to Fleming. Fleming misses the layup, and a foul is called on Matt Doherty.
Oh, what a great effort by Fern Fleming that time. He recovered the basketball on the snap away, took it in, missed the shot. Let's watch it one more time. Here's a second chance basket right here with Lamar Hurd going up strong. Look at him amongst all those Tar Heels. Come back again. Watch Fleming with the ball right here. You see Matt Doherty try to cut him off. He floats by him, gets his own offensive rebound, and Doherty rode him to the floor.
That is only the second team foul on Carolina. Georgia has four. Georgia doing a job on the offensive board. That shot by Crosby deflected. Here comes Carolina. Down to Jordan. Yes. Yet another slam. His third. Michael Jordan is filling it up. 23 points. He has 50% of the Carolina point production almost single-handedly, keeping his team in this game. Georgia by one. 47-46. Crosby trying to answer. Rebound. Corin has it blocked on him. However, Jordan was standing out of bounds, but he came down with the ball.
We talked about Georgia being able to take the basketball and run the fast break against North Carolina. North Carolina just gave them a chapter out of their own book on a stuff by Jordan.
Matt Doherty knocked the ball away. Doherty down to the floor. Scramble for the loose ball. It will belong to Georgia. Crosby and Matt Doherty really going after it. Both teams getting a little weary right now. We're going to have a timeout. 14.
Basketball. $50,000 for football. It costs $28 million, and they had it paid off the day they opened the door. We've got $22,000 plus on hand here today, and we've got a great Eastern Regional final between Georgia and North Carolina. 47-46, Georgia leading it.
Good matchup right there. Vern Fleming and Michael Jordan, you saw on your screen. Fleming's been guarding Jordan for the last three trips down the floor. Now Jordan's going to pick up Fleming.
Michael Jordan is 10 out of 17 from the field and 5 rebounds, 23 points. Matt Doherty, great defensive play, tips it to Perkins, and here comes Braddock and the Tar Heels.
Frank, I would think if North Carolina were to make a run here and get two or three baskets, you'd see Terry Fair come off the bench and get back in the game.
Braddock was a substitute last year on that championship team. Foul is on Crosby. It's his second. Great Carolina defense here.
Well, it is. Look at Matt Doherty. Good play right here. He does so many special things for you. He slaps the ball away. He's the guy that doesn't appear the next day in the paper as if he's done anything, but he really is a good role player for the Tar Heels.
You know, you hear the term role player, it is almost a negative term, like a player can only do one or two things. But Doherty is an example of a guy who does a lot of little things and does them very, very well. It is an integral part of this club.
Got it from outside, tipped up once, no good by Jordan. Next one to Fleming, down to Banks, James Banks in the drive. And again, they beat North Carolina down the floor. The Tar Heels just not getting back on defense.
49-46, Braddock answers for the Tar Heels.
They are shooting the ball well, and Jimmy Braddock and Michael Jordan are leading them right now.
Here's Fleming, left-handed hook doesn't go. Corin with the second chance basket.
What a basketball game. Both clubs going up and down the floor quickly, scoring. Excellent play.
51-48, Georgia. 13:20 to go. Michael Jordan. Both teams have to be getting a little weary here at the pace this thing has been on. Braddock can't get the shot. Jordan from 23. Crosby gets gets it across the center line and will slow it down.
Every time North Carolina has tried to push out to try to get a lead, Georgia has answered with a fast break basket, and they've got a chance now to push it out to five.
Their biggest lead has been four. Carolina's biggest lead has been only two. Fleming posted up with Redick. Got it!
At 6-5 and gets 6-2. Carolina needs a timeout.
This crowd is really raising the roof of the dome.
15, Carolina 4-for-9. We talked about Sam Perkins disappearing in this game. Sam has 2 points, two rebounds, 1 out of 2 from the line. And they've got to get somebody else besides Jordan into the offensive flow.
It's not a typical day for Sam Perkins. He's going to have to come alive here, or the Bulldogs are going to walk away with this one.
Braddock looking inside. Georgia's been beating Carolina down the floor just about every time.
Good change of defense right here. Good move by Hugh Durham. They went from man to man to their zone.
Brad Doherty with the miss. Georgia's ball. Michael Jordan says, no way. And that's the way that Bobby Deibler, the official, saw it. The rebound story so far, and it's been all Georgia. Despite the height disadvantage, the quickness and the leaping ability of the Georgia Bulldogs of Hugh Durham, that's been the difference in this game. 5-point lead for Georgia with 11:45 left to play. Corrin on the outside, and they're doing it now without Terry Fair, their big man in the middle.
That's exactly what I was getting ready to say. They're doing this without Fair, and every tick of that clock that goes down with Fair on the bench gives Georgia a little bit more impetus.
He's got 4 fouls. Gerald Crosby, 2! It up from 20 feet. 5 long-range field goals for the 6-1 sophomore. And it's Georgia by 7.
Georgia going to stay in that 2-3 zone. Brad Doherty going to anchor it in the middle. They've got Perkins and Jordan on the baseline. They'll look for Doherty or Braddock on the outside to shoot, or Perkins, Jordan inside.
Sam is open from 15. He can't get it to go. Again, Fleming beating Carolina to the ball. Vern Fleming. They are taking it to the Tar Heels. About them dogs. This would be the biggest upset maybe in the history of the NCAA tournament. You've got a team that's never been in the tournament before against a club that's been in 13 NCAAs in the last 17 years, including 9 in a row. And, of course, are the defending national champions.
Well, Carolina got a big break right there because Vern Fleming just committed a foul, and it was very close. If he'd come up with that steal and gone the other way for another basket, no telling what could have happened. But don't count North Carolina out of this game. They're an experienced club. They come back and they play well, and they've got outstanding players. But again, and we hate to keep reiterating this, but Sam Perkins has not played his traditional type of game here this afternoon.
10 minutes and 50 seconds separating Georgia from a trip to Albuquerque after the Fleming foul, and that is now 6 on Georgia. Carolina inbounding. Carolina has just 2 team fouls, so the Tar Heels will benefit from the bonus from here on in. Matt Doherty, the front, open from 20. Banks had that one knocked out of his hands by Jordan. Michael Jordan missing from 20. Perkins saves it. Redick comes down with it and is fouled by James Banks.
That time, and Michael Jordan, he kept it alive the first time. Perkins saved it that time from going out of bounds. He got it back in. Maybe that's a turnaround for him. Sam Perkins with a good save out of bounds. Carolina has a chance to recoup 2 of those points they've lost here in the second half.
Bonus situation now in effect for the North Carolina Tar Heels, and Braddock is on the line. They did a job the other night in the four corners, hitting those free throws down the stretch. Hugh Durham is almost out to half court talking to the official scorer. The front end of the 1-and-1, but Perkins is there with the tap-in. Sam Perkins with his second basket makes it 57-50.
Bad place to pick your dribble up.
Banks gets it across the line to Lamar Hurd. That basket by Perkins broke a 3-minute drought by Carolina. They have not had a hoop in the last 3 minutes as we hit the 10-minute mark in the game. 57-50. Corrin. Reverse layup. Great play inside. They got the back door, and Corrin went to the reverse layup. Good play by Georgia. 6-6 sophomore hits to build it back to 9. Matching Georgia's biggest lead. Inside to Sam Perkins. Perkins down in the
what's happened here. This crowd, which is basically a neutral crowd, is now smelling an upset, and the crowd is turning in Georgia's favor in a big way.
They're picking the Bulldogs up because they're the underdogs. Look at this move by Corin. Good reverse layup. Perkins there to attempt the block. He didn't get it. It caught a lot of steel up there, but it rolled around and in.
Crosby looking for help. Goes to Corin. Back outside to James Banks. Brings Jordan out with him. Hugh Durham down on one knee, shouting instructions to his Bulldogs, who lead it 59-50. Fleming off the Banks. Foul.
Michael Jordan may have committed the foul inside. Jordan and Banks with a good matchup right here. Two outstanding offensive players. That was Michael Jordan bumping into James Banks. He's got two.
Second foul on Jordan. And Banks gets a pair. Banks was the most valuable player in the Cotton State Classic earlier this year. 22,000 on hand, and right now the crowd definitely leaning toward Georgia as the crowd favorite. Got about 1,000 Carolinians up here. They sold that many tickets. But they're in the minority right now. 11-point lead for Georgia over the defending national champions from North Carolina.
Now those North Carolina fans are on their feet right now. They want something to happen for these Tar Heels. They're down 11, the biggest lead for Georgia in the game.
Alley-oop try to Perkins, and Perkins is fouled by Corin. Braddock saw him breaking under the hoop.
A good idea by North Carolina, and probably a good foul by Georgia right there, because Perkins had an easy layup. Corin probably prevented that layup, and he'll force Perkins to go to the line for two.
You know, Dean Smith, very innovative coach. He's the guy who started those huddles at the free throw line that you see so many teams now. Sam's season average at 17. You can see what he's done so far today. It will take a big finish to pull this one out for Carolina. There's Dean Smith. We said he is the father of the four corners, at least given credit for that. The huddle at the free throw line, how many other things. He's now deserves to be in the category of, I guess, your coach, your old coach, Adolph Ruff. Bulldogs, 8:45 left. Terry Fair is still on the bench. I imagine Hugh Durham doesn't want to disrupt this chemistry right now.
I don't believe I'd want to change anything the way they're going.
Trap on Corin, who gets away from it, puts it up.
Yes!
Oh, what a play! Got away from the double-team trap, and Richard Corin gets his third basket.
Sophomore just made a big play. Baseline drive, he was trapped, got out of it, and banked it off the glass.
James Banks got his fingertips on that pass intended for Jordan. Carolina saves it. They're down 11. Matt Doherty fouled as he goes up by Fleming.
How valuable are subs coming off the bench? This is one of them right here. Richard Corin with a good move right around Sam Perkins. He stopped. Perkins looked at him, and he banked it right off the glass. Boy, you got to have that bench, Frank. And Georgia's come up with a good one today in Corin.
Doherty on the line. Georgia on another tear right now, has hit their last six shots from the field. Matt Doherty, 2 out of 2 from the free throw line. He was fouled in the act of shooting, but again, keep in mind that Carolina's at least got the bonus working for them the rest of the half. They've only fouled 3 times here in the second half. That gives them 12 out of 13 from the free throw line. Of course, they've always been a good free throw shooting team. They shoot 73% as a team. Hunter coming back into the game for North Carolina. Curtis Hunter, he's a
Michael Jordan clone when you look at him.
Look for North Carolina to come out and put a lot of pressure on Georgia from here on out. He's got his small lineup in there now. Perkins is pretty good.
Good play by Fleming. Fleming takes it to the hole. And Perkins going up for the shot to block it. Housing. He wasn't afraid to take it in, was he?
He wasn't at all, and he took it right to Sam Perkins right there and Michael Jordan. Burn Fleming with an outstanding move to the inside.
3 fouls on Sam Perkins. Fleming, by the way, that foul a moment ago was his third. Fleming on the free throw line for the first time. He has 13 points.
interesting stat for him as a guard. He's the third leading rebounder on this Bulldog team. You've seen a lot of that today.
He's got six rebounds. Three of them have been offensive rebounds. A little unusual for a guard. 65-54. Georgia really lighting it up. And Carolina shooting around a 33% mark. Jordan, who was carrying the club, has cooled off the last 2 or 3 minutes. Draws the foul there from Corinth.
Surprised Michael Jordan didn't go ahead and shoot that basketball because it looked like Corn was going to bang into him anyway. He's a pretty smart basketball player, Michael is. He should have taken the ball enough and had the two. He's going to give him two anyway.
Dane Smith working the officials a little bit. He works them rather subtly, doesn't it? He doesn't just stomp up and down and scream and yell. But he lets them know that he's following what's going on. Jordan, not the first thing he's missed in a while. He's three out of four from the line.
Dean Smith should be a little bit concerned right now. We're under 8 minutes to play, and Georgia seems to be maintaining that same momentum they've had that carried them through the first half.
Another interesting stat on Georgia. They've got four starters over 75 assists this year.
Gives you the idea of the balance that they've had. They've got four guys in double figures, and they've also got four guys in excess of 75 assists.
Foul is on Perkins. That'll be four on Sam. And Smith looking like he's ready to go to his bench again. He said Sam Perkins went to high school in these parts at Latham. They got a correction now. That's a third foul on Perkins.
They've got the fifth team foul up there for North Carolina. Of course, North Carolina is in the bonus now with Georgia over the limit.
Banks, pull-up jumper. Well, there really she goes. Time Georgia goes down the floor, they come up with a basket, a free throw, something offensively, and they've kept the pressure on. After a very slow start by both sides, Georgia has played a near perfect basketball game. Perkins, left-handed hook, got it.
Nobody can do it better in the country than Sam Perkins right there with that jump left-handed hook right there. But if they're going to need a lot more of those today to get back on this one.
Foul is on Hunter. Three fouls on Hunter. Dean Smith trying somehow to help turn this club around. He said, you know, they were off to a very slow start this year, and they turned it around finally in Hawaii in a tournament with back-to-back wins against Oklahoma and against Missouri after they were 3-3. Front line scoring Georgia with a big edge. No mystery about that. This is the same thing they did against St. John's. They just beat them on the offensive boards.
And Frank, even with that front court scoring, you know, we talked about North Carolina height advantage. Georgia hasn't let it bother them.
Corin went up for the easy shot, intimidated underneath. He got by Perkins. Crown wanted a foul, and so did the Georgia bench, but it wasn't forthcoming. 6.5 minutes to go.
Now a chance for North Carolina to cut down that deficit from 10-8. Get under double figures.
Jordan has it knocked out of his hands. Great defense by the Bulldogs. Just as Jordan was about to go up. 12-point, make it a 10-point lead for Georgia at 67-57. Matt Doherty picks up the foul, his second.
Not a bad player to foul right there. Richard Corn is a 64% free throw shooter. He'll go to the line now. They're going to make Georgia earn it. They may take the game right to the line.
Brad Doherty comes back in for Carolina along with Steve Hale, the 6'3 freshman from Jenks, Oklahoma. Georgia continues to do everything right. Richard Corin, who's come off the bench replacing Terry Fair, who got into foul trouble, still done an excellent job. He has 7 points. 68-57. We could have a major upset in the making here in Syracuse.
And again, North Carolina trying to push the ball inside to Sam Perkins. James Banks slapped it away. I think this could be the largest upset, certainly in this NCAA tournament.
Well, everyone says experience counts so much. And yet, here you're looking at a team in the NCAA for the first time ever. And they've been playing ball since 1905 at Athens. Jordan with the miss from outside. Fleming and Jordan with the steal. Jordan planted on both ends of the floor. He hasn't given up. Michael Jordan. Off the hail, left-handed jumper is short from 20. Carolina, very poor shooting percentage here in the second half. And don't forget, they're doing all of this without Terry Fair, their big offensive player on the inside. Listen to this crowd here in Syracuse. They've adopted the Bulldogs. 5 minutes and 20 seconds to go. Georgia by 11.
Going to run some clock, Frank. They're going to pull it out and make North Carolina come out and play him straight up.
Who was Herschel Walker anyway?
He's trying to build a tradition at the University of Georgia. Boy, this could be the beginning of a great tradition right here to have a win.
Carolina's ball. Hugh Durham can't believe it. Can't believe the call. Goes to Bobby Dibler and says, give me a break, Bobby. Minutes 58 seconds left to play Eastern Regional from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. It's Georgia by an amazing 11.
A 6 out of 17.
Right at 33%.
A lot of that has been the Georgia defense, so they've really pressured Carolina into taking some bad shots.
Obviously, Jordan has cooled off, but I think Georgia maybe has changed its defensive alignment when he got hot.
Pretty good idea by Hugh Durham right there. He wasn't going to be content to sit back in that zone defense. He came out full court pressure, double team where he could, made North Carolina play.
Matt Doherty on the drive, rejected by Gorin. Look out. Crosby got it. Yes, and it will count. Gerald Crosby. And he was fouled.
Corrin with a great defensive play. They got it out front to Gerald Crosby. Watch Braddock try to slip inside. He couldn't do it. Crosby got the goal, but he missed the free throw.
Couldn't convert the three-point play. Still, Georgia with a 13-point advantage at 70-57 and only 4:20 left. Brad Doherty with the turnaround from 15. Dean Smith wants a timeout to discuss strategy.
And they've got to produce right now. They're going to come out full court. You see Sam Perkins at midcourt. The other three players are down in front. Nobody guards the ball out of bounds. Doherty is the floater.
So pressure by Carolina as Fleming takes the inbounds pass. Double teamed immediately down to Hurd. To Corin.
They're going to take it in. He's got it.
James Banks. Another follow-up basket. 18 points for Banks. Them on those second opportunity baskets. A putter missing from the corner. Georgia's ball.
You know, I find it interesting that Terry Fair has remained out of this basketball game by the choice of Hugh Durham. But right here, you'll watch North Carolina shoot the ball. Look at the box out right there by Fleming. That's why he's one of the leading rebounders on the Bulldog basketball.
Georgia again having no trouble at all, beating the Carolina pressure, getting it across the center line. 3 minutes and 40 seconds left to play. 72-59. The Bulldogs are looking at Albuquerque. Fleming with the miss. Traveling. Now the 6'5 junior from New York City. Here comes Carolina. Big Brad Doherty. 6'11 freshman. 17 years old. Wants to go to his first Final Four, but it's beginning to look distant. Here's another steal. Banks, 3-on-2 break.
That's a smart play right there. Gerald Crosby turned around, butted back out. They're going to make Carolina come out and play.
Foul is called on Doherty. That's his third. That's the time remaining. The Georgia Bulldogs in their first ever NCAA tournament are about to go to the Final Four, unless we have a miracle finish by Carolina. Hale is back in. Braddock comes out. Of course, Carolina, I'm sure, was pretty well geared up to play St. John. Do you think that was a factor?
It may have been. They maybe have been looking past Georgia. I don't think that they would have. Dean Smith would not allow that. He's too good a coach, and the players are too smart to realize that.
Jordan, who's been quiet for a while, gets his 11th basket. That gives him 26 points.
West, certainly Georgia would have to be in the East. We may have to have a couple pair of glass slippers in Albuquerque.
They are the only representative of the Southeast Conference left in the tournament. Lamar Hurd wisely calling timeout when he couldn't get the ball inbounds. That is Georgia's first timeout.
Great spectacles in sport.
And right now it looks like the defending champions are not going to be invited to the party. Michael Jordan with the foul.
Well, that's one man you really don't want to foul, because I don't know that there are any that you do want to foul, but Banks is going to go to the line. He has a 72% free throw average at the charity stripe and a chance right now to extend that Georgia lead.
Four fouls on Jordan. James Banks, who's had a brilliant game for the Bulldogs. 5 out of 5 from the line. 19 points for this 6'6 junior from Atlanta who came to Georgia with the intent of helping them build a basketball tradition. I believe he used all of it. 74-61. Carolina down quickly.
They got to get some shots up quick. Well, that's one thing you don't want to have right there. Richard Corin just committed a foul against Sam Perkins to stop the clock. Hugh Durham is telling Corin, don't stop the clock. Let it run. Let it roll. Now Perkins goes to the line. He can get two of those points back, and they can do it without any tick to the clock going off.
Brad Daugherty gets... not believing what they're seeing right now. 74-61 Georgia. Sam Perkins, who has not had one of his better days.
Frank, as it has been in most of the games in the NCAA tournament, it's gotten down to this level. You've got to make your free throws, and that's what Georgia's going to have to do to get in this basketball game and hold this lead.
Carolina is 15 out of 16 from the free throw line. That's the only battle they've won. Foul is on Braddock.
Pretty good foul by Braddock right there. They lost 1 second only. Now they're going to go to the line, and Georgia will have to continue to make those free throws.
Of course, Carolina's strategy right now has got to be foul them as soon as you can. Run off as little time off the clock as possible and put the heat on them. Make them do it from the free throw line.
We talk about Daugherty coming in on rebounding right there for North Carolina, but it doesn't seem to have helped them all day long because Georgia way up in that category.
Gerald Crosby missing the front end of the 1-1. That's how you get back into a basketball game. As a team, Georgia shoots 67% from the free throw line. Matt Daugherty. Oh, they can't buy one. I mean, Carolina has been stone cold in this second half. They trail by 2 at halftime. They are down by 11 with 2.5 minutes to go. Carolina is 8 out of 22 from the field. And the foul is on Jordan.
You got to make the front end of these 1-1s. Vern Fleming stepping to the line right now is one of the more prolific free throw shooters that Georgia has. He's at 72%. As a club, they shoot 67%.
Fleming, not the player on the Georgia squad you really want to foul. As he is their best free throw shooter, he and Banks. 3 out of 3 from the line. Fleming with a 15-point day and 7 rebounds on top of that. Hurd with the rebound down to Fleming. He'll want to slow it down here. Wait for the reinforcements. Run some time off that clock. Crosby in the corner. Just over 2 minutes left. Georgia with a commanding 13-point lead. Playing keep away now. Matt Daugherty took a slap at it. Didn't get it. Picked up the foul instead. Well, I think the Bulldogs can smell it.
I think they're there.
Dean Smith not ready to give up yet. And Hugh Durham ready to make his second trip to the Final Four. Once with Florida State,
And this time it will be with Georgia.
He can keep beating a dead horse, Frank, but they have done this without Terry Fair for the better part of the second half. He has not been in the basketball game, sitting on the bench with four fouls. Give the Georgia bench credit, Richard Korn in particular.
78-63, biggest lead of the day for Georgia. It is turning into a runaway. Perkins having trouble handling the ball. Has it blocked by Korn. Perkins staying after it, finally gets the slam. And Dean Smith will use his next to last timeout with a minute 44 to go. And his team down by 13.
Country in use this month for the various NCAA championships.
Crosby playing keep away. And this, of course, just one of them. So Carolina could do nothing but foul and hope that Georgia misses some free throws.
Terry Fair still on the sidelines watching most of the second half. He went out with four fouls, and Georgia just picked up the slack and continued to roll.
Georgia has dominated the backboards against a much taller North Carolina team. Crosby, now 4 out of 5 from the line.
Frank, I think if this points up one thing, it really establishes the Southeastern Conference as a really good basketball conference. Georgia came out of there, won the SEC tournament, and won it handily. And they've come on here, and they've beaten a good North Carolina team here today.
They were 9-9 in the conference. Matt Doherty with the miss. Georgia with the rebound. And the foul immediately called on Matt Doherty. Of course, as Hugh Durham pointed out, they lost something like 4 games by a total of 9 points. As you look at the Carolina bench, and their dreams are not of the Final Four right now. They'll have to be content with last year's honors and a runner-up finish in the Eastern Regional. Carolina's playing in its 9th NCAA Regional Final. 80-65, a very disappointed Carolina cheerleader. Michael Jordan. Tipped in by Brad Doherty is no good. Perkins with the next follow, but these are pretty well meaningless baskets at this point.
Well, with a minute 17 left, and the timeout right there taken by North Carolina. Georgia is up by 13.
What happens tonight?
Georgia in the second half has hit 61% from the field. Carolina has hit 33%. And Crosby is fouled by Jordan, and that's going to be it for Michael Jordan. So the great All-American from North Carolina has fouled out with 11 baskets. 4 out of 5 from the free throw line and a total of 26 points. Coming up next, the Midwest Regional Final from Kansas City, matching the Villanova Wildcats and the Houston Cougars.
That's a very disappointed Michael Jordan right there sitting on the bench. He's got his head bowed, but he really doesn't need to have his head bowed. He played an outstanding game here today.
A minute 14 left to play. Crosby keeps hitting those free throws. A disconsolate Michael Jordan. But he's got 2 years left. Much to the delight of Carolina fans. Jordan valiantly tried to keep in the ball game for a good part of the second half, but finally could not do it by himself. Everything going right for the Bulldogs. Well, there were few who thought that Georgia would win this game. Probably few who thought maybe that Georgia had a chance, but I'll bet you no one thought they'd win it like this.
No one in the country who follows college basketball could have anticipated a difference of 14 points with a minute and 10 seconds to go. You know, it might be a close game, though.
It's the importance, again, of getting hot at the right time of the year. And Georgia, as we said, got hot, breezed through the Southeast Conference Tournament. And right now, Hugh Durham has got them on an emotional and a play-in peak, which they're going to ride into Albuquerque with.
Well, Frank, there's always been a discussion about which basketball conference happens to be the most prestigious and the best in the country. And maybe this proves right now that the Southeastern Conference really did have a good basketball conference this year, simply because Georgia looks like it's going to make it to the Final Four. Kentucky got beat yesterday in the finals of their regionals in the Mideast by Louisville in overtime. So they both clubs represented the conference well. Georgia's going to continue to go.
Fleming's first miss from the free throw line. Impressive line he's got. 16 points, 7 rebounds. Matt Doherty taking it in for two. 81-69, 54 seconds left. Lamar Hurd trying to inbound the ball, having a little trouble there with his fingernail or his hand. Carolina, this would be their eighth loss of the season, so they'd wind up 28-8. And the Bulldogs would go to 24-9. And here is a team that has won 20 wins or 20 games for the first time in 40 years this year. And for only the third time in the 78 years that the basketball program has been in existence. Vern Fleming again on the line. Perkins to Braddock.
That's one thing you don't want to do right now is stop the clock. And goaltending calls do stop the clock. He should have let the ball go on up. It was missed. Let North Carolina get the basket, but let the clock continue to roll. Carolina is out of timeout.
10-point lead. 40 seconds left to play in the game. Crosby gets it across the line. His pass stolen by Perkins. Matt Doherty pushes it down to Braddock, who rides in for the layup. Braddock makes it an 8-point game, but only 25 seconds are left, and Hunter fouls Fleming. Dean Smith. They go back to 1946. This Carolina team has been in 9 Final Fours. In that time, they've won 2 titles. One of them, of course, last year. And a very happy Georgia bench. They can get the scissors out, huh?
But I have to get the scissors out, do some cutting on those cords up there. There's the North Carolina cheerleader, and there's the outstanding North Carolina coach, Dean Smith. I know it must be a bitter disappointment for the Tar Heels not to make it back to that Final Four, but they've got an awfully young basketball team. Jimmy Braddock, the only senior in that group that starts, and they've got good surrounding players coming back in Perkins and Jordan and both Dohertys.
Vern Fleming on the free throw line. Carolina has what? Just one senior, don't they, on that team?
Jimmy Braddock.
And Georgia loses a couple this year. Fair for one. Followed by Brad Doherty. 14 seconds to go. 7-point game. Again, it'll be Georgia and North Carolina State in one semifinal from Albuquerque next Saturday afternoon. And Louisville against the Villanova Houston winner. I'll tell you something. Smith has not given up yet.
His kids don't give up either.
As he can find a 7-point play here with 5 seconds to go. Tipped in.
He can hold it. He can hold the ball. Just hold the ball. Ball game.
That's it.
To go.
And Villanova by 1.